Let's say goodbye with a smile, dear.
I don't think anyone could be prepared for that day.
Well, we knew that we'd been prepared for an invasion, but we didn't know much about it.
I thought at first it was going to be a doddle, because there was no firing at that stage.
When, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. Keep smiling through, just like you always do, till the blue skies chase those dark clouds far away.
75 years ago today, these three brave men were plunged into one of the bloodiest battles the world has ever seen. A day that remains a kaleidoscope of memories, a signal moment of their youth.
I think everybody was nervous. We didn't know what was going into.
I was on the ship, the landing craft, in May. One afternoon, I just said to us, "Oh, we're loading up. Today we're going on exercises," you know. About 3 a.m, they decided to tell us what was happening. Special announcement was made that this was the real thing. You know, you just look around and you think, well, who's going to come through it, you know.
Bill Reynolds and Harry Fenn were just 20 and 19 when they landed in Normandy. It was a brutal journey into an even more brutal battle. Now, in their mid-90s, the emotions of that final assault on German rule still remain.
It was 3 days and 3 nights, continuous. The guns must be red hot. They never stopped. You couldn't sleep. And it was just bang, bang, bang all the time.
It was a vicious old war, really, if you think about it.
For 95-year-old Jack Rhodes from Guernsey, keeping morale up amongst the men was paramount that day.
When we landed, I tried to rally the troops that had survived the landing. I only had to say to them, "Come on, lads, we're not going to let them beat us."
Jack was just 20 when his battalion landed on Sword Beach. It's a day he'll never forget.
You see, our officer told us to get to the sand dunes and dig in, but we couldn't because they'd got snipers. We saw a girl coming along the road during all this action on a bicycle. And she said, we stopped her and said, "Hey, you can't go any further." She said, "I'm going to see how my grandma is." I hope she survived.
Well, it was just an everyday thing. You know, you'd come across dead Germans. And we didn't bury them or anything. We left the Pioneer Corps to come and do that.
Those people had to wrap them up and bury them. Some of them were terrible. Must have been.
One shell came over and landed 2 foot from my foot and spun in the ground, soft ground, and she came out again and exploded in the back. I was lucky.
This is the English side of the channel. Tank landing craft have brought the wounded to our southern ports. Red Cross orderlies gently hurry the men to waiting ambulances. We expected far greater numbers of injured, but we were mercifully spared heavy casualties.
Just how grateful were you that you did make it out alive?
Oh, it was such a relief. It was like coming out of a dark cellar.
I was damn lucky, very lucky, when I think about it.
For the friends that didn't make it home, will you always remember them?
Yes. Yes.
I've got a couple of friends that didn't make it.
The suffering was not in vain. The battle ended in victory. By day's end, Allied troops had successfully stormed Normandy's beaches, leading to the eventual liberation of Europe.
It's quite possibly the ultimate sacrifice to give your life for the good of others. Do you feel like heroes for what you did that day?
No. No, we had a job to do, we did it.
You were there, told what to do, and you done as you're told.
Came out smiling, think, well, we got away with it.
I didn't do anything extra special. I just did a job.